Welcome to Recipe Wars. My name is BC Hoffman, and today we are breaking down Cobb Salad.
I will be taking care of Ellie Krieger's Cobb Salad today, which for myself was actually a fun take on the Cobb Salad.
One Cobb Salad typically contains half the saturated fat you need for the day, which is the equivalent of almost 2 cheeseburgers. Well, luckily, I have found a way to make it just as delicious with all the same goodies, but very much healthier.
The dressing is a little bit lighter. It's gonna be more of an acidic olive oil and red wine and lemon juice, garlic, all that fun stuff. Now, the one big change that I did like and I didn't think I was going to was she actually adds ham instead of bacon. Now, for me, the bacon adds a little bit of flavor, but it's more of a texture thing. She actually also used poached chicken. So I think, all in all, really fun, great recipe, lighter than normal, but at the same time, still get the texture, still get the flavor.
I will be doing Cat Cora's recipe of Cobb salad. Now, what I like about her salad is that she uses a different vinaigrette. This one has apricot preserves in there, and it goes really well with the turkey bacon, the salty turkey bacon that she's using, as the creamy blue cheese as well. So I'm really excited about trying this new vinaigrette with the ingredients of the Cobb salad.
Today I'm doing Richard Simmons Cobb salad.
Sometimes a Cobb salad could have 20 or 30 grams of fat in it, but we're gonna make one that hardly, well, it has just a little teeny bit because we used a little bit of avocado.
It's a healthier version, and he's actually one of the few people who's doing it with the traditional watercress actually involved in the salad, which is kind of cool. He then goes with the motif of going completely vegetarian. Another thing that he's gonna be doing is he uses a fat-free balsamic, but I'm gonna be making my own balsamic just for you guys to enjoy today. So let's get this started. Now the true test, which recipe is gonna win this war? It's time to taste. We're going for this one first.
Okay. Go for her first? I'll just scoot down and go for you.
Come on over. The weather's fine.
And you know what's really cool? So you've got the saltiness, you've got the creaminess from both the avocado and from the cheese, and then you have that sweetness from the apricot preserve that she uses in the dressing.
Sweet, salty, and creamy.
Kind of hits everything. You get the full umami texture on the tongue. It's amazing.
I was actually going to say that about yours too. There's actually, the creaminess obviously comes from avocado, but you get a good hit of like sweetness, even from the beets in your dressing. The tomatoes are really ripe. It's really nice. The carrots are really fresh. It's a really fresh salad. Man, that's really, really good. It looks, for how basic it does look, you said minus the chicken and without the cheese, like there is a lot of flavor to that salad.
Yeah, those beets are really good variation to the Cobb salad.
Honestly, you can't go wrong with homemade vinaigrette. I'm gonna give this one a whirl too. Now I noticed you guys have the eggs going on in yours. Mm-hmm. I love eggs in a salad. When you're cooking it, you end up getting that greenish-gray ring around the yolk, and that's from overcooking. And it's also basically the sulfur that you have in the egg white mixing with the iron in the egg yolk. Combined, you get that.
Well, actually, I found the best way is to put eggs in cold water in a pot, and then you just bring that water to a boil, and you take it off of the heat and put a cover on it and just let it sit for 12 minutes and you have the most perfect hard-boiled egg. No grayness to it, it's yellow and it's white, and hence you get this beautiful color you have right here on all of our Cobb salads.
Man.
Well, Alita, I have to say, after tasting yours, it's really, I guarantee I haven't had mine yet, but the closest thing to a Cobb salad, especially with the turkey bacon, it's really good. I mean, the flavors just pop everywhere. The dressing is really, really good. You know, you use the egg white and egg yolk this time, right?
Right, right.
I know yours called for either or.
What I like about yours is yours actually, I mean, you can really taste the Dijon in your dressing. Like, it's very, very strong in there, and that's a great thing in the salad. The other thing is that grilled or sauteed ham that you have in there. Now, you can use any ham. I think her recipe calls for Black Forest. I'm a sucker for maple glazed or honey.
Yeah.
I would totally go with one of those just because
I love sweetness.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Just another flavor to your salad.
Exactly. And another good way to do it, I would grill the chicken so it gives another boost of flavor to the salad without overdoing it. Yep. Which one do you say is the winner? I'm in a standstill, and I'm actually genuinely surprised. I hate to say it, but my least favorite is yours. Mm-hmm. I was genuinely surprised by Richard Simmons. I mean, the fresh beets makes a big difference. I would totally go fresh. So I'm really gonna toss it between these two. I mean, for a vegetarian Cobb salad, this is awesome. the dressing is really the killer with the beets. Yeah. But for just an overall traditional or as close to traditional Cobb salad, I hate to say it, but I think you're the winner.
Do I win? I win?
I think I was going to say I'm a big fan of Lolita's as well. I mean,
I think my dressing is is money. It just what makes it different.
Yeah, we weren't. I know we weren't trying to do anything super different from the original recipe. So I think she really kept it as close, but still incorporating different flavors and things to the Cobb salad side. That's why it's definitely my favorite dish. One thing I did notice, and like I said before, I wasn't a big fan of the poached chicken. In the recipe, and I did it myself, she adds a little bit of lemon to the water, and you can actually poach it in other things besides water as well to give it even more flavor. But I would have, like you said, gone with more of a grilled or something to add just a lot more flavor, because it's just one more punch that you add to that salad.
Just
that
like
I think
the grilled avocado.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. This is definitely missing. It's just not, the chicken isn't really adding anything, whereas like yours is a perfect example that you don't need meat for it to be a great tasting salad. I think this isn't really adding that much of an addition to the salad.
This has been Recipe Wars. Please subscribe to our page, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, and catch us next time for the next Recipe War!